you are part of one of the biggest of the big. But I like looking at those lists, and I love everything in that batch. Is there any other teen romantic comedy that came out in the 90s that you watch all the time?
Ooh, that I watch all the time? I'm a sucker for the old John Hughes ones. I don't mean to sound like a purist, you know what I mean? But, like, let me think. Like, have I seen 10 Things and Varsity Blues? And that's not technically wrong, but kind of was. Which other ones were there? Help me.
My two go-to, in addition to She's All That, are 10 Things I Hate About You. And I was also very, very into Can't Hardly Wait.
I love that movie. Those are directors and writers of Josie and the Pussycats. I love that movie. I actually went in for that movie. And apparently that's how they end up casting me and Josie. It was off of that because they had already, I went in for the Love Hewitt part. She was already in negotiations. I think I was brought in as a backup meeting. But luckily they remembered me from that. I love Can't Hardly Wait. That's, I think maybe that's the best one of that era. And it's a little bit outside of that era. It was years later, but I have a major soft spot for that movie, She's the Man. It's hilarious.
That there's a movie that doesn't get enough credit. People do not talk about She's the Man nearly enough.
People have been sleeping on She's the Man.
It's so funny. I'm also going to tell you, I might have a Can't Hardly Wait CD off to the side right now, but even though I have the VHS player, I don't have a CD player to play it.
Oh my God.
It's like no laptops even have disk drives.
Power to get us to, come on. Can you, do PS3s play? No, they don't. Oh, I don't know. No,
I don't know either. My poor PS4 is like sitting unused in LA right now anyway. You already brought up Josie and the Pussycats, so I'll go there next.
Yes, please.
I guess let's start with like the harder part. So you pour all that time into that movie, and then I know, like, you're an actor, there's only so much that's in your control once it's finished and it's sent out to the world, but then it doesn't do well at the box office. How do you process that, and how do you kind of, I don't know, not get bogged down by the negativity that comes with that?
Well, what's great about being 20, who's basically a teenager, when something like that happens, is that no one really explains to you that it's not just not great news, it's news that's going to continue to affect you in a very real way for a long time. And truthfully, only time can kind of show you that. So I understand why no one wanted to raise their hand and be like, this is not good for sure. But it was not. Like, we all sort of went to what's in the industry called movie jail for that box office quote unquote failing. And it took many years for people to get that movie. And I'm just glad that we made something that I'm still proud of. And I have, you know, it was a little bit of a bumpy road onward from that, but I don't know, we have something great to show from it. And we're talking now about a movie that I really love. So I guess it all turned out the way it was supposed to be.